Hello friends, I am Virbhadri Adhemaya from VVSM Academy, situated in Kalyan Nagar, Bangalore. Today I would like to divert your attention towards the science subject chemistry, particularly carbohydrates. Well friends, carbohydrates are nothing but sugars. They may be non-sugars also. Together classified as sugars and non-sugars. Simple or complex. Simple carbohydrates, often called monosaccharides, disaccharides, oligosaccharides, are simple sugars. Simple carbohydrates, often called monosaccharides, cannot be broken down into smaller carbohydrate molecules. But disaccharides undergoes hydrolysis under acidic conditions, results in the formation of two monosaccharides, which are simple sugars. Polysaccharides undergoes under acidic condition, hydrolysis results in the formation of simple sugars, simple units. During the chemical reaction, acid hydrolysis, the glycosidic linkage or ether bond or oxygen bridge are broken down. They will see that monomer molecules breaks and a number of monosaccharide molecules are formed. Animals and human beings consume disaccharides and polysaccharides and digest. Hydrolysis takes place in the presence of enzymes, which are called enzyme reactions, hydrolytic reactions. Polyhydroxyaldehydes and polyhydroxyketones are nothing but carbohydrates because of they contain carbohydrate group and keto group. Aldehyde group contains the monosaccharides, which are called aldoses. If the carbohydrate contains keto groups, that is carbonyl group, which are nothing but ketoses. Carbohydrates are produced from carbon dioxide and water by plants through the process of photosynthesis. We have discussed so many things in the photosynthesis in our classes by plants. The photosynthesis takes place. The primary function of the carbohydrates in living organisms is an energy source. Carbohydrates is the energy source. Many of them are easily digested by animals, where they are converted back into carbon dioxide and water with the concurrent release of energy. Well friends, carbohydrates structures and classifications are concerned, sugars and non-sugars. There are many structures which are going to be discussed today: arabinose, fructose, glucose, galactose, mannose, ribose, and xylose, which are considered as simple sugars in the carbohydrates. Monosaccharides are nothing but simple sugars, as I told you. And coming to the disaccharides are lactose, maltose, and sucrose. You know, my dear friends, lactose is made up of two units by the oxygen bridge, the glycosidic linkage, which is made up of the glucose and galactose. Maltose is made up of two sugars, which is nothing but two glucose molecules. Sucrose is made up of two units by the glycosidic linkage, is derived from glucose and fructose. Well friends, coming to the polysaccharides, which are the complex carbohydrates, can be broken down into smaller carbohydrate units through the process of hydrolysis. You know, examples of carbohydrates are given below. The polysaccharides are starch, glycogen, cellulose. You know, starch, glycogen, and cellulose comes under the polysaccharides. We will discuss later in the next class. Well, friends, the carbohydrates, sugars, structures, and classification. Arabinose. This is arabinose, where you can see arabinose consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbonates, 5 carbon atoms, that is pentose, it is a pentose. Fructose, galactose, and glucose, they are hexoses because they contain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon atoms, hence they are called hexoses. Hexa means 6. Now, coming to the banose, you can see it's an aldehyde. See, it's aldehyde group, and it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is also a pentose. Mannose is also a pentose. Coming to the ribose structure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a pentose. Here, xylose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is also a pentose. So pentoses and hexoses are the important simple sugars in the classification of carbohydrates. These are the structures. The many isomers are there in this structure. We will discuss isomerism in the next coming classes. Well, friends. Now, we coming to the carbohydrate structures and classification of disaccharides. They are simple. And these carbohydrates are broken down further into sucrose, further hydrolysis acid. Hydrolysis gives glucose and glucose. Lactose is going to give the products, simple sugars like glucose and galactose. And maltose, this is the maltose, which is made up of two glucose molecules. So non-sugars are concerns, as I told you, complex carbohydrates are broken down by the smaller carbohydrates units through a process known as hydrolysis. A common carbohydrates are shown and given in this table below. Obviously, these are the starch, glycogen and cellulose are the important polysaccharides. Well, friends, let us discuss about the action of sulfuric acid on sucrose, disaccharide. Sucrose is a disaccharide. You know, it is chemistry is a wonderful subject. We can come across the reactions dealing with the carbohydrates. Sucrose undergoes a hot and dilute sulfuric acid. Acid hydrolysis gives glucose one molecule and fructose one molecule. That is hot and dilute sulfuric acid. Suppose, my dear friends, let us discuss about what happens when the concentrated sulfuric acid, about 98%, what happens? First, dehydration occurs. You know what is dehydration? Dehydration is nothing but the removal of water molecule from the respective compounds here. Sulfuric acid is a strong dehydrating agent, as we know, which means that it can abstract water from the substance then with which reacts. So when sulfuric acid is added to the carbonates or carbohydrates and sugar, it removes hydrogen and oxygen. This is a simple chemical reaction. Sucrose undergoes charring reaction takes place here, a vigorous reaction takes place here because of the concentrated sulfuric acid. It gives oozing of carbon, as shown in the figure here, you see. This is the figure. Now, you know, because of this vigorous reaction, the black graphitic foam is coming out from the beaker when you are mixing sugar, that is sucrose, and concentrated sulfuric acid. This is nothing but action of sulfuric acid on sucrose. Well, first, dehydrating agent. Sulfuric acid is a very good dehydrating agent, a strong dehydrating agent. Dehydrating is nothing but removal of water molecule from the compounds. For example, here, first reaction, sucrose, sulfuric acid, carbon charring out. Sulfur undergoes dehydrating, sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. It removes, now you see, it removes water molecule. In every reaction, sulfur, sulfuric acid, sulfur dioxide and water, sodium chloride, sulfuric acid, sodium hydrogen sulfate and HCl. Here, copper oxide, like this. In almost all cases, the respective carbon dioxide gases and water molecules will be removed. This is nothing but the charring action of sulfuric acid, which reacts with sucrose, 98% concentrated sulfuric acid, nothing but charring reaction. Now, coming to the another important point of view is sucrose, structure of sucrose. The two, as I told you, the sucrose is made up of two molecules of glucose and fructose. When it is acid hydrolysis, you know, glycosidic linkage. Here, during the presence of enzyme, the glycosidic linkage, that is oxygen bridge. This is the oxygen bridge. This oxygen bridge is going to break because of the acid hydrolysis. It slips, split into the hydrogen and OH, then hydrogen atom attached to this. When the glycosidic linkage is broken, the water molecules breaks and the respective H and OH molecules attached here. Here is the respective, this is a hydrogen, it becomes OH here and here OH. The respective glucose and fructose will be formed during the chemical reaction. This is nothing but acid hydrolysis. Glycosidic linkage is broken here, the ether bond is broken, the oxygen bridge is broken, and the respective hydroxy group is attached to the respective glucose and fructose respectively. And hence, the glucose and fructose are formed.